In the margins of the seminars, I made it clear that there was absolutely no point in my making any recommendation unless it works both for the press in its dealings with those who might be the subject of stories and with the individuals involved. It must work for the necessary relationships between the press and the police and the press and politicians. But most of all, each aspect must work for the public. It must have an ethical base to which all adhere. I therefore encouraged editors and those in responsible positions within the press to meet to discuss these issues outside the hearings that I am conducting and to bring forward ideas. These ideas must reflect the fundamental freedoms to which I have referred, but it must also recognise that guarding the guardians is not an optional add-on. Neither is it good enough if it does not take account of legitimate public concern, not only about phone hacking, but also other unethical behaviour not justified by what is truly in the public interest. Concern has specifically been expressed that those who speak out might be targeted adversely by the press as a result. I have absolutely no wish to stifle freedom of speech and expression, but I anticipate that monitoring will take place of press coverage over the months to come, and if it appears that those concerns are made out without objective justification, it might be appropriate to draw the conclusion that these vital rights are being abused, which itself would provide evidence of culture, practice, and ethics, which could be relevant to my ultimate recommendations. I also recognise that there is a great deal to applaud in our present press, and I certainly do not intend to limit my consideration to activities which could be the subject of criticism. It is critical to place everything in context.